Thank you.
On y va?
Ready.
Maya?
Where is he?
You might prefer privacy.
I would not.
To holy matrimony, then, and whatever further perforations you may put in it.
Excuse me. Let yourself go so. Sorry, Monty.
It's good to see you again, Mrs. Thomas.
It's Mrs. Porcher.
Not yet. Now, don't blame poor Cody. He was overdoing what I told him. My name never suited. Thomas not proper enough.
It's another name for shame.
So now you're all snug and proper, are you? Marrying this fawn.
Why are you here, Edward?
Well, there's a certain section of the bar here. The left side, I think, significantly enough. Where your groom and his gentlemen friends like to call on each other. Now, I assumed, for symbolic purposes at least, that the wedding would be held there. I had assumed, you see, since my invitation never arrived.
I would invite you to hell.
No need. Already there. Too bad you never cared for it.
In spite of caring for you once.
Well, my fault then. You offered care, I needed passion. What does the fawn need? Can you supply him? Charlotte, not with everything. And what can he give you?
Pride.
Don't turn your back on me, Mrs. Thomas.
It's so funny. From what I remember, it was the position you most favored.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Wait!
Mr. Thomas, you have the most peculiar sense of timing.
You think you can make her happy just because you won't violate her delicacy, because you don't need her as a woman?
I think maybe we define woman differently. I don't define it as punching bag, for instance.
Cole's not like you. He creates, you destroy. And as you can see, you're a failure even at that. Let's get married.